Sometimes when you're recording a musical idea, you want to keep recording so you can capture all your different takes and then later on select the best out of the lot. We can do that with loop recording. Aside from that, we can also go back in and select certain portions from different takes to create the best possible take. So let's take a look at how we can do that. Now let's take a look at loop recording. So we have a loop recording button here. I'll enable that. We also have this blend recording or overdub button. Let's check out what happens when I turn this on and we record. So firstly, I'm going to set up a range for loop recording. I want to record the entire arrangement, so I'll hold down Command, click and drag and activate these four bars for my selection. And now let's go ahead and record. So it should be obvious what was happening over here. We did manage to loop record, so every take that I recorded was maintained, but also every take was audible when I'm recording the previous take. Now this can be helpful for some kind of a live looping performance, but that's not what I was going for. I just wanted to record again and again and select the best take that I performed. So generally, you want to turn off that blend recording mode. All right, so let's record again. I'm just going to right click and delete these takes and try it again. Alright, so now you notice how every previous take was being muted. In fact, pretty much all the takes are muted right now. So if I get out of record mode and hit play, we don't hear anything. So now we can audition individual takes by unmuting them. So this was the first take. Let's try the second one. The third one here. Fourth one. So that can be very handy. Record multiple takes and then pick the best one that you like. Now on top of this, we don't have to specifically select one entire take. We can select segments from individual takes and create a composite or a hybrid take that has all the best individual segments. So to do this, we're going to make use of the slice tool to chop up all the different takes. I'm going to chop them up into bars. So let's say cut all these four here. So that's one bar. And cut all these four over here. So that's my second bar. And then lastly, cut these ones here. Now you can choose to slice this up any way you like, depending on which parts you want to keep. But I'm just doing this as a quick example. All right, so now I just have to unmute certain takes that I think I'm going to use. So let's try this one here. And then maybe right after that, I'd like to use, let's use this take here. So I'll unmute this one. Let's hear how that flows in. Interesting. And then maybe we go to this take over here. Unmute this one. And then lastly, let's go to this take here. Now my edits are not quite clean. If I zoom in here, you can see how a little bit of this chord was cut off. So I don't really need this, so I'll trim this back. Same over here, I do need this. So I'm gonna trim this one back. Let's move this back here. Maybe this one too. All right, so now let's hear this. All Very nice. And again, keeping in mind, all these takes are going into that same insert on the mixer. So that's mixer number 7 here. Let's solo this. Sounds quite dry, so let's add some effects. I'm going to choose slot 1 here, and I'm going to add the fruity reverb 2. I'll choose a preset. Let's go for a small studio. I also want to add a chorus. I'll choose a vintage chorus. Bring the mix down a little. That sounds good. Let's hear this with everything else. All right, so that is loop recording in the playlist in FL Studio.